Module 7, Chapter 3. Welcome to the third chapter of Module 7. This chapter provides a framework for thinking about how to act on the results of your data analyses. You will explore the process for interpreting your results, generating implications, and making recommendations. After analyzing your data, interpret the results to answer your evaluation questions. Then, examine the implications of these results to generate recommendations. This process may require you to make complex judgments from competing results within your context. Involving stakeholders at this stage may be helpful, even when disagreements arise. The following slides provide a framework for working through these steps. When interpreting your results, it is important to understand the limitations of your data. Is the sample representative? Is the sample large enough to act on the results? Were the analyses appropriate? Do the results justify the conclusions? Are there alternative explanations for the results? Are the results considered in their context? With these questions in mind, you can now complete the analysis plan you started earlier. In Module 3, you identified an evaluation design associated with each question. Then, in Module 5, you completed an evaluation matrix for your program. The final two columns of the matrix describe how you will analyze data and interpret findings. Here, the AMP evaluation team shared an analysis method and interpretation for the evaluation questions: to what extent do students complete homework with better than 80% accuracy, and what barriers exist that prevent students from completing homework. If you are confident in the interpretation of the findings, you can move on to making recommendations. Useful recommendations are based on your evaluation questions. To ensure that your recommendations are useful, you can apply the PARSEC framework you used to develop evaluation questions in Module 2. Your focus is slightly different here, particularly on whether the findings can inform actionable recommendations. Recommendations should be pertinent in that they relate back to the evaluation questions. They should be actionable or able to be implemented. They should be reasonable, making use of available resources. They should be specific, as in clear and well-defined. They should also be evaluative, accounting for the values of stakeholders and leading to a judgment of some sort. Finally, they should be complete in that they address key areas described by the evaluation questions. How might you apply the PARSEC framework to a single recommendation? Keep in mind that you can't examine completeness, the C in PARSEC, in a single recommendation. In the AMP example, the evaluation team finds that several students were unable to complete homework because they didn't have computers at home to access online assignments. The team makes the following recommendation from that finding: allow students to check out laptops to use at home overnight. Does this recommendation align with PARSEC? Let's see. Is the recommendation pertinent? Yes, it directly relates back to the evaluation question: what barriers exist that prevent students from completing homework? Is this recommendation actionable? If the school has enough computers for such a policy, or the funds to purchase more, then yes. Is it reasonable? It probably depends on what the local context is and whether such a policy would be seen as appropriate, given the resources on hand and the community the school serves. Is the recommendation specific? It could probably be more specific. For instance, which students will be eligible? What will the consequences be if a student fails to return the computer? Such details might make the recommendation more actionable. Finally, is the recommendation evaluative? Again, it largely depends on how stakeholders view the recommendation. This concludes Module 7. You can now proceed to Module 8, which covers the best ways to disseminate your findings and visualize your data.